from New York City, we bring you Jean Hersholt in a new Dr. Christian drama called The Music Box, presented for your enjoyment by the Cheesebro Manufacturing Company, owners of the trademark Vaseline, and producers of Vaseline Petroleum Jelly, Vaseline Hair Tonic, and other Vaseline specialties. If you are one of the many thousands of people suffering from winter head colds, here's some simple good advice. You can get relief from that dry and stuffy feeling by applying Vaseline jelly up each nostril. The heat of the body will melt it and distribute a soothing, harmless film over the irritated membranes, bringing comfort and easier breathing. And if your throat feels dry and raspy, take a spoonful of soothing Vaseline jelly. People who live in dry climates especially can use Vaseline jelly to advantage every night before retiring. The medical theory is that protecting the nasal passages helps to prevent germs from getting a foothold. Remember, Vaseline jelly is absolutely pure and safe. It contains no harmful or irritating ingredients, and it costs only 10 cents at all druggists. And so to this evening's Dr. Christian drama, The Music Box, starring Jean Hersholt in his most famous role, the country doctor. Mr. Hersholt will be supported tonight by an all-star cast, including Rosemary Brancato, young American opera star, Josephine Hull and Martha Scott, both of whom played leading roles on Broadway last season, and Irene Hubbard, Burford Hampton, and Frank Butler. The curtain is rising on the first act, and the scene is our little white village church where a wedding is in progress. Dr. Christian, a trifle late, slips quietly into a back pew next to old Miss Mary Lufkin, who lives in that whitewashed stone cottage along the river road behind the high white wall, where she raises heliotrope trees and mimosa and things nobody in River's End ever grew before. Seated on the other side of Miss Mary in the church is her hatchet-faced companion, Francis.
Well, Miss Mary, this is an unexpected pleasure.
Ben begged me so hard. I couldn't refuse.
Oh, Ben's a good lad.
He's helped me with my garden and taken care of my lawn for the past 10 years, ever since he was a schoolboy.
Well, I've known him longer than that. I brought him into the world 25 years ago.
Oh, madame.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Nothing.
You're ill?
Oh, no. It's just so warm in here.
I told you it was foolish to come.
Would you like to go outside for a minute?
Oh, no, thank you. I'll be all right.
I'll go with you.
No, I'd rather not. It would attract so much attention.
We could step right out the side door, you see.
People would all stare and wonder.
Madame, doctor, she's fainted.
I'll carry her out.
Oh, do leave a god that this should happen.
Go ahead, Amine, and open the door, the vestry door. We can't get out the other way. The wedding party will be coming in. Feeling better now?
Yes. But so ashamed of myself.
Oh, you needn't be.
And so remorseful to think I made you miss the wedding.
Tell me, are you subject to fainting spells?
No, I never did such a thing before in my life.
You were feeling quite all right beforehand?
Oh, yes,
The air was very close in the church.
Was it?
And so heavy with flowers. The odor of lilies has always made me feel a bit faint.
There were no lilies.
No? Well, then, it must have been roses or something else.
I think what you need right now is a cup of tea.
And I think she ought to go to bed.
I don't want to go to bed. I couldn't rest if I did.
Tea for two. That is, if I may stay.
Of course. And bring us some brioche with the tea, Francis.
Oh, very well.
Now, what can I do to make myself useful?
Oh, you could move the tea table over here in front of the fire.
No sooner said than done.
Please. Please.
What?
That was it.
I don't understand.
That song. You were just whistling.
Oh, promise me?
Yes. It was hearing that at the wedding that made me faint.
Oh.
It was so many years since I'd heard it. I hadn't even played it on the music box.
The music box?
Over there.
Oh, yes. Oh, what a lovely box. I've noticed it every time I've been here and admired it. But I didn't realize it played music.
It has been closed for a long, long time.
May I look at it?
Oh, certainly. Open it if you wish.
No, I won't do that.
I'd be glad to have you. It's quite unusual inside, the way it works.
The case itself is exquisite. Never saw more beautiful inlay work.
Yes.
It's very old, I imagine.
Very old.
Let's see, is that a... Oh, that's a date engraved on the lid, eh?
No, those are initials.
To be sure. M.L. from K. Fun H. M.L. Mary Lufkin.
No. Magda Lupina.
Magda Lupina.
Did you ever hear of her?
No, I don't think so.
No, you wouldn't have. She never sang in this country.
So? She was a singer?
Yes. She made her debut in Vienna almost 50 years ago as Margherita in Faust. Her first role and her most popular one. She sang it at La Scala, in Budapest, in Dresden and Munich and Prague. She was singing it one night in the Royal Opera House of Moldavia, a principality which no longer appears on the map of Europe.
Flowers, probably.
Heaven knows where we'll put them.
Yes?
Madame Lupina?
Madame Lupina can see nobody.
For just a moment.
Madame Lupina receives no visitors between acts.
But in my case...
She makes no exception. Now you'll have to wait until after the performance.
But there will be so many people around her then. I wish to speak to her now, alone.
If you will give me your message, I will deliver it.
Ah, but it is of such a personal nature.
Well?
I wish to tell her that I think she is divine... That she...
Who is it, Francesca?
An impertinent young gentleman, madame, who does not give his name.
Allow me to introduce myself, madame. I am...
His Royal Highness, Prince Karl von Hovenberg.
You recognize me?
Certainly. It is the face at which I stick out my tongue every day, the face I pound so with my fist.
What?
Madame.
Every time I put a postage stamp on a letter in this country.
Huh? Oh, I dare you to do it now.
Madame.
Oh, you have the most beautiful laugh I have ever heard, madame.
I love to laugh.
And so do I. Oh, but there are so few a prince can laugh with.
Madame Lupina, curtain in 2 minutes.
Oh, I must go.
Oh, when may I see you?
In exactly 2 minutes. On the stage, if you will go back to your box.
Well, no, I mean alone, where we can talk.
Well, I...
After the performance, for supper.
I've already promised the Comtesse de la Roche.
Break it.
But...
I'll be at the stage door with my carriage.
Your Highness...
Madame Lupina.
Yes, coming.
Good.
Oh, I wasn't talking to you.
Let's have supper, then. Half feet is in.
Where did you ever find it?
In the shop of an old bohemian. You like it?
It is the most beautiful music box I've ever heard. The flower song from Faust. Oh, Carl.
In my life to surrender her night to be.
That one on because...
Because you knew Faust was my favorite.
And because Faust was the first opera I ever heard you sing.
All of 2 weeks ago.
When you had finished, I wanted to gather up all the flowers in my realm and lay them at your feet. I wanted to lay myself
and
at your feet,
Trumbly,
too.
And here, Trumbly, this is another of my favorites.
Oh, Magda.
Which one shall we play?
Magda, I can't keep the words back any longer. I've waited... Till now.
Oh, here's a lovely number from that new Dukhobin opera. Do you know it?
I know only one thing, Magda, and that is I...
I'll play it for you. Listen.
We'll take our love together to some sky where we can be alone and faith renew.
You like it?
It was written for me. It says all that is in my heart, all that I feel and hope and long for. Magda.
Yes.
Will you?
Will I?
Promise me that someday you and I...
Carl.
You do love me, Magda?
Yes.
Oh, my darling. My beautiful.
I too was singing from the heart. My song.
Our song. Oh, Magda. Magda.
The curtain is dropped now for a brief intermission in our Dr. Christian drama, The Music Box, during which I wish to present a guest who has something to say that we think will interest you.
I suppose a lot of men feel about the way I did when my hair began to get dry and hard to keep combed and shed white dandruff flakes on my shoulders. Nothing I did seemed to help. Then I came across a Vaseline hair tonic advertisement about dry scalp, and I decided to let Vaseline hair tonic help me. I massaged it freely on my scalp before shampooing, and in addition, I used a few drops each morning to dress my hair as I combed it. I just wish you could see for yourself what Vaseline Hair Tonic has done for my hair. My wife says it never looked better. It stays neat now, and the dandruff scales have disappeared. I never used anything like Vaseline hair tonic before, and I'm glad of this chance to pass the word along to others.
As a sensible way to guard against dry scalp, thousands of men use Vaseline hair tonic every morning to groom the hair, and before every shampoo to supplement the natural scalp oils. Vaseline hair tonic is different. It contains no ingredient which might dry the scalp, and it's very economical. A few drops do the trick. You'll find Vaseline hair tonic in handy shaker top bottles at any drugstore priced at 40 and 70 cents. Get a bottle today. The curtain is going up now on the next act of Jean Hersholt's Dr. Christian drama, The Music Box. The scene is Magda Lupina's exquisite apartment in the capital of Moldavia. It's afternoon of an early spring day, and Prince Karl has called upon her as usual.
Do you mind, Magda, if we don't go driving after all?
Stay inside on such a lovely day.
It would be better, madame.
I don't understand.
There has been some rioting on the streets lately. It is nothing, just some students, but we might find it unpleasant.
Rioting? About what?
Oh, you know how students are. If they can't find one thing to protest about, they'll find another.
You are the cause, madame.
I...
Francesca.
Oh, she might as well find out now as later, Your Highness. She's bound to find out.
Find out what?
How the people of Moldavia feel about this liaison.
How dare you use that word, Francesca?
Oh, that's what all the newspapers call it.
There has been talk in the newspapers.
Plenty.
Why did you not tell me this, Carl?
It is nothing. It will soon blow over.
Oh, I might have guessed. After that demonstration in the gallery the other night.
Again, that was only a group of students.
Students? Yes. They're always the leaders. It was the students who first revolted against your cousin Ludwig of Bavaria.
I have no cousin Ludwig.
Years ago. She was a singer, too. And a dancer.
What are you talking about?
Her name was Lola Montez.
Oh.
In the end, he lost his throne because of her.
What has that to do with us?
You two are a prince.
And you are the woman I love. The only woman in the world.
Listen. What is that?
A crowd down on the street around His Highness' carriage.
Let me see. Open the window, Francesca.
Magda.
I want to hear what they're saying.
There is nothing to hear. They are simply waiting there.
Open the window, Francesca. They sound ugly, Carl.
Don't worry. They'll do nothing as long as...
I am not with you. I understand.
Oh, Magda.
Go, Carl. Go now. And let them see that you are alone.
Oh, but...
Go.
You really wish it?
Yes. Please.
Very well. I'll come back later. This evening.
No.
Oh, tomorrow, then.
I'll send you a note.
Promise.
I promise.
Till tomorrow, then. Oh, my sweet.
Goodbye, beloved. Francesca.
Yes, madame.
Watch at the window and tell me when His Highness comes out of the building.
Yes, madame.
How long will it take you to pack, Francesca?
You mean...
We're leaving here.
When?
By the first train to Vienna.
Oh, madame.
Sometime tonight.
Madame, you promised His Highness.
That I would send him a note. I will. It shall be delivered to him tomorrow morning.
Oh, madame.
Together with his presents, which I'm returning.
The jewels?
They're royal heirlooms, Francesca. I have no right to keep them. I should never have accepted them.
Oh, it's a pity. You're giving back everything.
No. There's one thing I shall take with me. The music box. The present he brought me the day he told me he loved me. Open the window wider, Francesca.
Madame.
It may be that he can hear it.
He's coming out of the door now, walking down the steps. The crowd is parting to make way for him. He's entered the carriage. He's looking up, madame. I think he hears you.
No love less perfect than a life with thee.
Driven away. He's gone.
beloved.
Late that night, two women left the hotel in a cab with drawn curtains. Along the dark cobblestone streets it clattered, past the opera house, placarded with the name of Magda Lupina, who would never sing there again. She knew that Carl would follow her and find her anywhere in Europe. So she set sail for America.
Where she became Mary Lufkin.
Yes.
Did you ever hear from him again?
Only once, and then indirectly. It was during the war. For years, I had been living obscurely in a large city.
Chicago.
Why, Dr. Christian, how did you know?
Go on.
In all that time, I had not sung a note in public. I'd vowed I never would again. But the war, with its emotional appeal, was too much for me. I heard of plans for a great benefit performance for the Red Cross, and I volunteered my services. You can't imagine what a thrill it was. Walking out upon a stage and facing an audience again after all those years. Suddenly I felt young and beautiful, and my voice that night surprised even myself. And then the blow fell.
Someone recognized you?
Yes, Joseph Tauchnitz, former equerry to His Royal Highness.
What did you do?
He came up to me, called me by name, and he said he still loves you, madame.
And so, once more, you fled.
Yes. And after that experience, I knew that I must find some place more obscure, more remote, if I was to have any peace of mind.
And so you came to Riversend?
Yes. With Francesca and this music box. My only two links with the past.
You say that Moldavia is no longer in existence?
No. The World War erased it from the map. Like so many little principalities.
So, Carl lost his throne after all.
Yes.
Then what?
And then he married his cousin. She was dumpy and she had thick legs, but she had a kind heart. And I knew his people were glad to have him marry at last, a princess of the blood.
You loved him so much. And to have him forget...
He has not. Forgotten.
If he had really...
Read the account of the wedding. It's here in this clipping.
Oh. There was one untoward incident during the wedding reception which created a slight stir. The orchestra had just started to play the popular number, Oh Promise Me, when the prince stepped forward and commanded that it be stopped. He appeared very pale and agitated. No, he has not forgotten.
You are the only person, Dr. Christian, to whom I have ever told my story.
There's only one thing you haven't told me.
What's that?
How you happened to come to Riversend when you left Chicago?
It was by the merest chance. After the concert that night, I went to the porter's desk in the hotel to get maps and timetables and found him in the act of checking some baggage for a guest to Riversend. The name caught my eye. River's End. It sounded like the kind of place I was looking for. So I bought two tickets, and that's all.
Not quite. That baggage that was being checked, do you remember it?
No. I couldn't possibly tell you.
But I can. There were two bags, brown cowhide and rather shabby, with the initials PC.
Paul Christian?
Yes. I was the guest who was taken out that night. I'd stayed over to attend the Red Cross benefit concert.
But then you've known all along.
Only that you were a great singer who, for some reason, did not wish to sing.
And you never said a word.
Oh, it was none of my business.
Dr. Christian.
Oh, I'll admit that I've been curious as the devil.
For 20 years, you've helped to guard my secret. Oh, you are good.
Oh, doctors learn to be close-mouthed.
You've done all this for me. Will you do one more thing?
Just name it.
When I am gone, if you are still here, will you send word to...
To Carl?
Yes. And tell him that I kept the music box as long as I lived. And that then, It was given to you.
To me?
Please.
Miss Lufkin. I mean, Madame Lupina.
And so the curtain comes down on another Dr. Christian drama. Our star, Jean Hersholt, will be out to greet you in person in just a moment. Meanwhile, may I say a word about the products that make the program possible? These are the days when colds strike quickly and often. So it is especially important now to keep a jar or tube of Vaseline jelly on hand. A little placed up each nostril lubricates the nasal passages and soothes the tender membranes. And for a dry or raspy throat, there's nothing like a teaspoonful of Vaseline jelly. When you buy, be sure to look for the trademark Vaseline. This is your guarantee of quality and absolute purity. Remember, too, that Vaseline jelly is the base of other worth-knowing products, such as Vaseline borated jelly, Vaseline carbolated jelly, Vaseline camphor ice, and Vaseline lip ice. Ask your druggist about their special benefits. The artists you heard tonight were Josephine Hull, Martha Scott, Irene Hubbard, Burford Hampton, and Frank Butler. The singer was lovely Rosemary Brancato, young American opera star who created a sensation in the Hollywood Bowl last summer. Some of our listeners, perhaps, were there. The artists are all standing now to take a bow. Now our star steps to the microphone. Mr. Jean Hersholt as Dr. Christian. Say, that was a beautiful music box, Mr. Hersholt. Where did you get it?
It was lent to us for this occasion by my friend Dr. Bruno Sutton of Ithaca, New York. And believe it or not, he acquired it from a grateful patient.
Ah, and thus we see what inspired your play tonight. Well, tell us what kind of a story you've selected for next Tuesday.
Next week's play is about old Joe Grannis, who shelled peas and wiped the dishes for his sister Hetty for 50 years longer than he needed to. It's called Have a Heart. Until next Tuesday evening, then, I'll say good night.
The Jean Hersholt Dr. Christian Show, Have a Heart, will come to you next week at the same hour from the Columbia Square Playhouse in Hollywood, California. Hollywood fans, please note. Andre Baruch announcing, this is the Columbia Broadcasting System.